Yeah, that's 7th and Wilshire. Going to LAX.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and the guy wants to get there sometime day before yesterday.
Hey, Jess, how's it going?
Hi, Billy. Friday madness has set in. I think my ear's gonna fall off any minute.
Check Jurgen's mileage. He likes to take us for a ride sometimes.
I've noticed.
Cab a cab.
Tiffany, come on!
Okay, okay. We're going to the Laker game tonight. See you later, guys.
Cream.
Why don't you honk?
Bye, Tiffany! Have fun at the Laker game!
Mom, did you see Jenny's new jacket, the one with the studs all over it? Wasn't it neat?
Yeah, it looked great. It also cost about 70 bucks.
But Mom, this one's all fraying.
Well, why don't you patch it up? You know, buy some studs for yourself. And put it on yourself. It'd probably look great. Probably even better.
Mom, it's falling apart.
Well, then maybe we ought to learn how to do with what we've got.
I'll have your money.
I swear!
Get in the house, both of you. Go, 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 come on. God, what happened?
Come on, come on.
Oh, right.
Somebody tried to rob the van.
Are you all right? Stay away from him, Matthew.
But Tiffy, he's hurt.
I owed a guy some dough. I got a little cash flow problem.
Little? Van, let me take you to the hospital, please.
I told you, no. Hospitals call the cops. The cops question me.
What have you got to hide? And you already said that it was just watches and cameras that he fronted you the money for. And if he's threatening you over that, then they should know. Give you a little protection.
Look, I don't want him involved. You understand?
I mean, I've got $1,000 in my savings account, and maybe my sister and...
What the hell kind of good is that gonna do me, huh? If I don't come up with 10 grand in cash by tomorrow, they're gonna kill me.
What are you talking about?
I'm telling you, these guys are serious.
Oh, man. Man, what are we gonna do?
If I can just make it through this thing tomorrow, I'm picking up 20 grand the day after. I'm getting in with these serious investors down in San Diego on that shopping center. From there, it's everything we ever dreamed about. Billy, I think I know where we could get it.
Where?
It's only till Sunday, you know. Sunday I could pay it back. Well, you know, baby, by tomorrow afternoon, there's got to be at least $10,000 in cash at the cab company after a Friday.
You want me to steal it?
No. I'm saying borrow it over the weekend till Sunday when I could give it back. Monday morning.
Mom! Hey, Mom! Are we going to go to the game?
Just a minute, honey. Let me get him settled and I'll be right back. Here you go, just like the four of them.
Minus the Lakers.
I know. I'm sorry, guys. Next week we'll all go, okay?
I'm sure. Is Van okay?
He'll be all right. You watch your mouth, young lady. Van's gonna be around here whether you like it or not.
Whether you like it or not. I'm not going next week either.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah. Are you really going to get the cash back on Sunday?
Yeah. Honey, I'm telling you, the deal was all set to go through today. $20,000 is sitting there waiting for me at the lawyer's. That's where they're getting together and signing.
Yeah, but on a Sunday?
Yeah. I talked to him this afternoon. I wouldn't put you through something like this if it wasn't 100% certain.
Couldn't something go wrong?
Absolutely not. One of the investors was out of town, but he's coming back tomorrow and he wants to clinch it Sunday morning.
So you can promise me that you'll have the money back here by Sunday?
You have my word. You're gonna put it in the bank Monday like nothing happened. You know how much I love you, don't you?
Not that bad coming in on a Saturday.
Yeah. Well, I gotta take my kid to the doctor on Monday, and I figured that I'd probably make up for the lost time now.
Oh, okay.
Billy, what are you doing?
Sorry, I forgot.
Oh. Yeah, Jess, I'm down here.
I don't know how good an idea this is, considering you're acting like you already had about 12 cups this morning, but coffee's on, if you want some.
Is that 765?
No, thanks, Jess. You're right. I did.
Thank you.
Honey, I won't be able to see you tonight. I'm paying these guys off, and then I'm driving down to San Diego for the meeting tomorrow morning. You'll be all right, won't you?
When will you be back?
I told you, tomorrow night. You have dinner ready at 7, and I'll be there. $10,000 in my hand.
Did you talk to your lawyer? I mean, I have to deposit this stuff.
Calm down, huh? I spoke to him, and everything's copacetic.
Oh, thank God.
I gotta go, baby. Billy, you keep this as quiet as a grave. We'll laugh about it down in Acapulco.
No. I feel a little ill. Do you guys mind taking the bus today?
No.
No. You gonna stay home?
Mm-mm.
Want me to stay and take care of you?
No. No, you go to school, baby. You got bus fare?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Feel better, okay?
Okay. Jess? Yeah, I'm not gonna be in until about 12 today. Well, tell Schrader that I'm gonna be a little late. But don't let him have anybody else do my work for me, okay? Okay, thanks.
Hey, Jesse, what time did she say she was coming?
12 o'clock. She had to take a kid to the doctor.
Can't wait for her. I miss the bank.
Mom, Mr. Donahue asked to put some of my poems in the literary magazine.
You gonna give him any?
I don't know. Would you look at them? I don't think they're good enough.
Elizabeth Nickerson. I have a warrant for your arrest.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent, anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
Tiffy, call Aunt Janice.
You have the right to speak with an attorney. You have the right to have an attorney present with you during questioning. If you so desire and cannot afford one, one will be appointed to you at no charge to you before questioning. Do you understand these rights? Ma'am, do you understand these rights?
Mom, there's no answer!
Keep trying!
keep trying!
We're gonna have to take you two kids to protective services.
What are you doing?
Are we under arrest too?
You've made no provision for their care. They're going to a temporary shelter.
No! You can't take my children!
You can't hardly leave them here neglected and abandoned, can we? Take him to protective services.
You can't take away my mom! Help
me!
Janice, what's happened to my kids?
Well, they're at my house. I picked them up today.
Oh, thank God. Are they all right?
Not really. They sent them to a home that takes kids in an emergency.
Did they say anything?
They think it's some kind of terrible mistake. They can't believe you did anything wrong. Did you? Did you do this for Van, Billy? What'd you let Van do to you, Billy?
Nothing!
Honey, please. I know you a little by now.
What do you know? Did you know we were going to get married?
I know he called.
Well, Janice, what did he say? Where is he?
He didn't say much. He didn't even say where he was calling from. He woke us up in the middle of the night.
And?
He said not to worry. He said he'd be back to get you out of here.
I knew it. He's okay, isn't he? He didn't get into any kind of an accident, did he?
He sounded perfectly fine considering the hour. Let's just hope he's telling the truth this time. Bob and I went to the bail bondsman today. We just can't swing it. And Mom won't ask her husband, so...
I figured on both counts.
Don't put this on me. He's the one that did this to you and your kids, not us.
Lay off of me, will you? I don't have the kind of magic life you do. He said he was going to come. He'll get me out.
I hope so. But I wouldn't hold my breath.
He will. You'll see.
Billy, you don't steal $10,000 and then have nothing to say about it. Well, look, if you gave it back, maybe I could get you probation. If not, they can make things a lot more difficult.
I don't have it.
Well, who does?
I told you I can't say.
Your sister thinks she knows.
My sister thinks she knows everything. She doesn't. She's wrong.
Let me just make this clear. If you go to trial, your boss is out to nail you.
What if I just try to pay the money back? I wasn't trying to steal it. I was just trying to borrow it.
Look, if you just tell me what you did with the money, maybe I'd have a case. With a conservative judge on the bench and your attitude, Billy, you have two kids. There's no father. It's your neck.
understand that you're pleading guilty to the charge of felony grand theft?
Yes, Your Honor.
I see she has no prior record. Was fully employed up till the time she was arrested. The children, Tiffany and Matthew, where have they been, huh?
The children have been placed with the defendant's sister, Your Honor, as dependents of the court.
I see. Miss Nickerson, this is hard for me. But the court adjudicates the defendant guilty of the offense with which she has been charged and remands her to the custody of the State Department of Correction to be held in the California Institution for Women for a term of 3 years. Subject, of course, to standard parole procedures. Deputy, please remove the prisoner.
Mommy! Don't let him take you!
Aunt Janice will take good care of you. We'll get through this.
I can't do this, Jamal. Not your fault. Tell them. Tell them it's a mistake. Please.
Over to my mother's and three at my husband's. Where are yours at?
No, my sister's taking care of them. She's got a beautiful house in Northridge.
Yeah, well, you're lucky State didn't snatch them. They do, you know.
Okay, ladies, follow me and follow the instructions given to you.
Why don't you watch where the hell
you're
going?
Hey, just stay out of my face,
get out of here.
Okay, that's enough, ladies.
Come on, hurry up, move it along. A lot of people gotta eat here. Move it along. Go, go.
How'd you get in front? Suck up to the chef?
Judge sent me here to be your personal pain in the butt.
That why he gave you a nickel more than I gotta do?
Yeah, I guess anybody'd get off easy if they snitched like you.
Those two pop off regular as firecrackers on the 4th of July.
You ought to put them out of the way someplace.
This is out of the way.
Attention on the yard. Inmate Garcia, report to your job assignment. Inmate Garcia, report to your job assignment.
Come ahead, ladies. Remember what I told you, keep your nose clean, follow the rules, and your stay here will be uneventful. Form a column of twos up ahead, please.
Like I said, they know. They know who's a fish, who's in on a new beef, who didn't make a street time. Before you ever set foot on this yard, they know everything about you.
Hey, Baumgarten, know your wife's getting it on with the yard officer?
Yeah, she told me all about it. Takes the pressure off me.
Heard she was back.
You want a picture, huh? I'll autograph it for you.
Don't mess with her.
Why?
Because she runs this place. That's why.
Officer Wyler, report to the watch office.
Officer Wyler, report to the watch office. And Jurgen, Steiner. Dickerson left, Peter's right.
You get the top bunk. I love that bunk guard. He's fine from any angle.
Problem, our Papa will take care of it.
Thanks. Yep, that's what they've been calling me since 64. Called my mom that too when she was in Quentin 40. Her mom was in jail before her. My boy's in the federal pen in Marion. Guess if I had a daughter, she'd be here too, huh? Yeah, jail runs in my family like diabetes.
Do it. This is
like the third time this week. Yeah, so good. You mind? Hey, free country. 5 minutes and out. Mm-hmm. This here's Billy. Angie. And Rhonda.
Hi.
Hi.
What are you doing?
Oh,
what's your problem?
Looks like Billy's gonna need a laundry girl, huh?
I don't need anything.
But Rhonda does. M-O-N-E-Y.
If I had any M-O-N-E-Y, I wouldn't be here.
Not real money.
canteen credit. You put your pay on the books. That's how it works. She does a good job, too. Pick up and delivery.
I'll do my own laundry, thank you.
It'll put a permanent crease in your jeans.
I don't need one.
Yes, you do. Shut up.
Attention on the yard. Yard recall. Yard recall. All inmates report to your housing units for count. The yard closed.
All right, Sue, put the ball up. Let's go.
Daddy?
Nobody wants to be. We were supposed to be getting married.
He dogged and ran out on you, right?
No, that's not what happened. I know he's in some kind of trouble, though, because otherwise he would have gotten in touch with me by now.
Otherwise he would have gotten in touch with me by now. They all say that. Including me. My boyfriend dogged me, and I still got his picture up on the wall.
Yeah, well, that's too bad, but that's not what happened to me.
They all start out as stubborn as you, too. I ain't blaming you. It's like trying to take booze from a drinker until they're really ready.
I don't have to listen to this. Van loves me.
Yeah? Well, I bet you a six-pack of soda and a whole bunch of candy bars. He ain't sitting around staring at your picture, girlfriend. Wherever he is.
Oh. Hope they're home.
Some way to raise kids, ain't it?
Okay. All yours.
Oh, yeah.
I want to grab that, Jeremy. Tell him we're eating.
Hello. Mm. Oh, hiya, Billy. Hey, it's your mom.
Mom? When are you coming home?
Not for a while, sweetie. But I'm going to try and call you once or twice every week, though. How does that sound?
But I want to see you. Mom?
Hi,
Tiffy.
Hey. I miss you. How's your new school?
Okay. My English teacher's not as good as Donahue, but the others are okay. How you doing?
I'm a little lonely. That's okay. Hey, are you going to write for the literary magazine in that fancy new school of yours?
I don't know yet. I've been writing some poems, but...
And they're excellent.
Well, Jan, hey, Tiff, are you going to send me some?
Sure. Mom, are we allowed to come and see you?
Well, that's just what I wanted to talk to Aunt Janice about. How about the two of you hanging up for a second, okay?
Yeah. Sure.
How is it there, Billy?
Well, it's not as bad as the movies. Do you think that you could bring the kids out?
Well, I don't know. I've got a lot to handle right now.
Please, Janice.
I just think they've had enough upheaval in their life for a while without seeing their mother in prison.
Please. It's not so bad.
Janice.
It'll be much worse for them not to see
me at all than to see me in here.
Can't I just send you the forms and you think about it?
If you want. But I doubt I'm going to take a Saturday or a Sunday away from my boys. They only have half of me lately anyway.
Have you heard from them?
No, Billy. Do you want me to put the kids back on?
Okay.
Okay. Time's up.
Oh, jeez. My time's up. Tell them I'm going to try and call them Sunday, okay?
Those kids are having a hard enough time as it is.
But she's right. It'll be much worse if they don't see each other. Look what's going on with Matthew, getting in fights at school every day. Tiffany's grades dropping.
And you think they're going to improve if she sees her mother in a place like that?
At least she'll know where she is. They need that, Jan. If you're not willing to take them to see your own sister, I will. Matthew!
Stop!
Matthew!
Stop!
What is all this?
He started. He always does. I don't want him here. I don't want him here.
Shut up. You call my mom a loser.
Did you say that, Grant?
That's what Mom told me.
Did you, Jen?
No matter what I said, nothing justifies us beating up Grant like that.
Matthew, I want you to apologize to your cousin and...
If he doesn't straighten out, we're going to have to make some drastic changes in this living arrangement. Come on.
I hate this place. I want to go home.
It's all we have. Let's try to make the best of it.
Attention on the yard. Inmate unready. Report to culinary. Inmate unready. Report to culinary.
She'd never believe.
Boy, she sure is beautiful when she's mad.
Get out of here. Get out of here.
Okay, what did you do with it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't give me that bull. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
I'm sorry. I don't have the slightest idea.
You stole my clothes.
What's up?
Hey, it ain't my hustle. Now you get out of my way, punk.
Ladies. Ladies. Have a little laundry problem here? Nickerson?
Everything's copacetic, Mr. Bunker.
Good. It's just the way I like. Shouldn't you be at work now?
Yeah, man. What's happening? Hey, girlfriend. What's happening with my curlers, you know?
Subtract the two cartons of cigarettes you
own. And the little grass.
And that makes a split 30-70. Told you she does good work.
Yeah, only I'm not paying for it. I got kids to worry about, not creases.
You want me to feel sorry for you, is that it? Forget it. It's free. It's on the house.
What do you mean it's on the house? She owes $10. I ain't into no charity work.
How come?
Hey, you didn't snitch out there with Bumgarten, right? Let's just say, I like your style. Rhonda, don't buck me in front of the new meat, huh?
Well, don't be using me to suck up to it.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that. Just this once. Don't go out.
Attention, please. All visitors must observe the following. Anyone caught bringing controlled substances or contraband into the prison will be prosecuted to the full extent of the law. Decorum must be maintained at all times in the visiting room.
Come on, folks, step right over this way. A lot of people waiting. Right through here.
Yeah. I'm nervous, though.
Bring your wallet in as long as there's no more than $20.
Sure.
Changers only work for ones and fives. For the vending machines, the inmates aren't allowed to handle any money.
All visitors must observe the following. Anyone caught bringing controlled substances or contraband into the prison will be prosecuted to the full extent of the law.
Genius. Oh, I love those poems.
Thank you.
Hi, Janice.
I got something for you.
Thank you. So how's Bob and the kids? Oh, they're fine. Everyone says they're loved. What happened?
One of those lady cops opened it.
Well, they're not really cops, hon. They're correctional officers, and they're not really that bad. Oh, look. Well, I guess every time I have coffee, I'm just gonna have to think of you. Thank you, baby.
Thank you.
So how's school? Got any new friends?
I don't like anyone there.
You don't? What about you, Tiffy? I bet you've got plenty of new friends to tell me about.
You're kind of snobby in Northridge.
Well, Tiffy, I think it's just a little bit awkward being at a new school, isn't that it? And also she's a little bit embarrassed about not being with her real family. What do you tell them?
Well, Jeremy said you were in the hospital, so that's what they all think.
They do not. They really think you're in the funny farm, Mom.
Well, that should be interesting when I get out.
Well, Jeremy just slipped, and well, you know kids. After that, it just caught on. Kids, why don't you go get a sandwich for your mom and me, okay? Billy, what would you like?
Beef. No, tuna. No, make that yogurt. I haven't had that for a long time.
Okay, yeah. Go get whatever you want for yourselves.
He's having a hard time of it, isn't he? They used to be so good together.
He's impossible. I don't know if I can handle him any longer.
Well, what's he do?
He beats up Grant. He gets in fights at school. He's causing tension between me and Bob, the boys.
I'll talk to him. I'll straighten him out.
Okay. But if it doesn't work, I'm going to have to find another place for him to stay.
Not at Mom's.
No, I don't think so.
Well, then where?
Mm-hmm.
sorry, man.
All B's, right? And two A's?
Yeah.
Oh, she's good. She's on the activities calendar. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Now, when we talked about it, she was going to change that.
Visiting will be over in 5 minutes. Five more minutes. Visiting will be over in 5 minutes.
Okay, now remember, you're good, and Janice will bring you back to see me again soon.
Okay.
The trash is in the window, please. Janice, I know you haven't said anything. But I was wondering if you'd ever heard anything from Bam. How can you even think about him? Look at your family. And mine, too. If he ever showed up, I'd call the police. He never even called. No.
He's gone. He cleared his stuff out a couple of months ago. He's never coming back.
And good riddance. It's the only decent thing to come of all of this.
Hard day, huh? Sometimes seeing them's worse than not seeing them.
Freaking her out, right, Lee?
I'm just telling you like we wish somebody had told Becky last year.
I know, but her sister didn't say for sure, okay?
Besides, ain't nothing you can do about it now, honey, so you might as well just enjoy it.
Hey, watch out! Watch out.
Be back in five.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah, you too.
I got something for you.
What's the game?
No game. It's a present. Come on, take it. What do you think? Somebody's gonna snitch to your old man? Huh? I've got an old man on the outside. But that's there. This is here.
I don't have an old man, boyfriend, lover, anything anymore. And I'm not looking for any substitutes, okay?
Okay. I get it. I'll take it. No strings.
Thank you.
Hey, Angie, what happened? You've fallen.
Listen, girl, you better stay out of my face. You're gonna be sorry.
Oh, What's the matter, huh? ¿Qué pasa?
Staying awake ain't gonna make it all right.
You better try to get some sleep, child.
Happy New Year, right?
You're a really good dancer, Anna.
So are you.
I'm young.
Now this dance?
Sure.
I'm really glad you moved out here, Tiffany. You like it?
Sure.
Hey, you want to do something really fun?
What?
Well, I drove my brother's scooter up here tonight. You take a ride?
Really?
Yeah. It'll be great. It won't take long.
Okay. It's dark in here. I don't know where the light is. I can't find a thing.
I can.
Scott, where's your scooter?
In a minute, Tiffany. This is nice.
Scott, don't you think we should go back to the party? Scott, stop! What are you doing?
Don't act like you don't like it. I'm sure your mother likes it plenty.
You don't know anything about her.
I'll see what's wrong.
Matthew, did you tell anybody where mom is?
7 minutes until that magic hour.
I want to know, Matthew. Did you?
No.
Don't lie to me. Scott knows. His sister's in your class. Did he tell her, Grant?
Yeah, he did. I heard him. So what? I'm sick of lying about it. I don't care anymore.
You're not sick of lying about everything else, you disgusting little jerk!
Matthew, go to your room.
Great, now everybody knows.
Big deal. It's better than her being whacked out in some mental institution.
Not for me.
Yeah. Wasn't that good resolution left? Wanna dance? Come on, it's New Year's.
Yeah. constable wants to see you after 11 o'clock count.
What for?
Your son's run away.
Do they know where he is?
Police picked him up near here. Now he's a dependent of the San Bernardino County Court.
Does that mean I don't get him back?
Oh, I don't think they can make it permanent just like that.
Well, what should I do? How much time does it take? I'm going to be here for another 9 months, even with good time.
Oh. I don't know. It's up to the judge and the county, the foster family, if there is one. It's not my department.
Mr. Anderson, isn't there anything that you can do? Don't they give out a number where he's at least?
Young lady, I have read you everything that is in here. There's no mention of whether he's in a home or a shelter or what.
I've got to find him. How do I do that from here?
Hey, Nickerson, you on strike or something? Why aren't you at your assignment?
I can't go back there again, Mr. McQuinn. I just can't. My baby ran away.
Well, it's not going to do you any good to lie there copping a 115. You want to lose another 30 days on top of it, and that's just for this afternoon.
Angie, you know the ropes around here.
Only way to survive. What's up?
I don't know what to do. My kid ran away and Anderson won't help me find him.
Look, if I'd listened to every time they told me no, I'd have cracked a long time ago. There are some do-gooders from the outside. They call themselves community outreach. With more clout than Anderson's going to be happy about. Now, you ask to see them, and if they don't help you, come back. Okay?
Thank you.
I'm sure that we can track down your son for you, Billy. But what do you want to happen then?
I don't know what can happen. I just can't get any straight answers around here.
Well, I can, much as I know. First of all, did they tell you about the court hearing?
Huh.
Figures. A hearing comes up after Matthew's been in the court's custody for 6 months. Now, that's only 4 months down the road in June. It's to review his case, you know, make certain his situation's okay, see if there are any new considerations. You have the right to be there.
Yeah, but...
But you'll give up your work credit for the day.
Who cares?
Okay. Now, how long have you done?
Let's see, starting with county, 6 months out of 18, 19.
Billy, once you've been away from Matthew for a whole year, they have the right to take him away permanently. And that's just 2 months after the hearing. Now, that doesn't mean it'll happen for sure, but the judge could decide that it's better for Matthew to be in a stable environment than it is to wait another whole year for you to get out.
Yeah, but Susan, I didn't want to leave him.
I know it's not very fair. But it's up to them.
You know, sending me here is one thing. Take him.
my kid away from me. That's another. You know, Mr. Anderson, I may not have many rights here, but I didn't hear any judge telling me that I was going to lose my rights to be a mother. And I intend to go to that custody hearing that you forgot to tell me about.
Well, you do, do you? Do you realize, Miss Nickerson, that we'd have to receive a court order first?
I'll do whatever I need to help you file for it. Where do I start?
Okay. You write your social worker. You write the judge. And I'll do my part. Oh, God. Satisfied?
Yes.
Oh, just a second. Community Outreach wanted me to inform you that they've located your boy. It's with a foster family not far from here.
Thank you.
You see? You study your rights. You can drive these people crazy. Oh, but did he tell you about the old 1 year to reunify?
You know about that?
I didn't make it once.
You've got a kid?
Did have. Roberto. Hell, for all I know, his foster family's probably adopted him.
Yeah, but Angie, don't you want to know? I mean, you're the one that's always telling us not to let him do that, not to take our rights away.
I don't want to know. I decided a long time ago. You can live in here or out there. But if you try to live in both at the same time, it'll cut you in half.
Janice is busy. Can't you take the bus just this once?
Mom, I just don't want to.
Why?
Billy, she finally has some friends to do things with weekends. And since Matthew ran away, she needs...
Can I talk to my own daughter, please?
Mom?
Tiffy, what is it? Is it so awful to see your own mother? Anymore?
Okay. All right, I'll come next Saturday.
Tiffany!
Yeah?
Marcus is taking everyone who got a beer over on the final to the Dodger game. He said it's the only way to shake the cobwebs out of my brain.
You mean... You got an A.
You made it. You're going.
When's the game?
Next Saturday.
Can you go? No problem. I'll be there.
Great.
Cool. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah,
on, let's go.
I did it. Get in there. Go.
Two. And you should be off. Inmates Reynolds, Gonzalez, and Scott have a business.
She's not coming.
She's got to come. She promised. What time is it anyway?
Time for visiting to be just about over.
I'm going to try to squeeze in a phone call. Something's happened.
Move it.
No way, punk. I ain't getting off of you.
Try me then, anytime.
Okay, Rhonda. What are you doing? Get out of here.
Yeah, could you try 818-555-1757? Collect for Tiffany Nickerson from Billy. Yeah, thank you.
Ask me what your opinion was.
Yeah, all right, Billy, that's it. Sorry.
You got a light?
touch it, Sylvia.
Tell it to the disciplinary committee. They meet the day after that.
You could have held your arms up to shield yourself. But instead, you fought back. I'm taking 60 days work credit. And that's giving you a break.
If I stay here an extra 2 months, I could lose my son. I may have lost him already.
Well, you should have thought of that before.
You mean I should have just let her beat me up?
Those are the rules.
I'll do the paperwork.
Welcome back.
You missed my kid's hearing ordeal.
I know, but Susan showed up for you. They're having him stay with his foster family 6 more months, and then there'll be another hearing.
You're kidding.
No, it's true.
We have to start all these again from scratch. You write your social worker again. You gotta write the judge. This time, try to keep your nose clean, young lady.
Don't worry about it, Mr. Anderson. This time, I finally got my priorities straight.
Yeah? That's what I'd like to hear. Okay. If you stay out of trouble for at least 90 days, see if maybe I can get your time back, too.
All right.
All right.
Mrs. Arnold, this is my mom.
All rise and come to order. Division 1 of the court is now in session. The Honorable William Chadway presiding.
Please take your places and we'll proceed. This is a hearing to determine the placement of Matthew Nickerson, now in the temporary care of Mr. and Mrs. Richard Arnold. How are you faring with the Arnolds, Matthew?
Okay. They treat me pretty nice.
And his schoolwork, how's that going?
There's been a real improvement, Your Honor. It appears that this stable environment is very good for him. And we should consider putting him up for adoption.
What is she talking about?
Mrs. Arnold, has the social worker discussed this with you?
Yes, she has, Your Honor.
Would you consider adopting the child?
Yes, Your Honor, we would. Can they do that?
Miss Nickerson, can you tell me how much longer you expect to be incarcerated?
Yes,
Yes, Your Honor. Only 3.5 more months.
But you realize you will have been separated from your child for a total of 19 months. And just what are your plans upon release?
To find a job and to stay with my sister until I can find a place of my own for my children and me.
That's the sister from whom your child ran away?
Yes, Your Honor, but he ran away because he was so unhappy without me, not because he was being mistreated.
Matthew, is that true?
Yes, sir. I was only trying to go see my mom.
This is your first incarceration?
My only one, Your Honor. Believe me. Your Honor, am I allowed to say something for myself?
By all means.
I've had plenty of time to think about what happened. And I know it was wrong. Horribly wrong to put anything or anyone before the good of my children. But I love Matthew and his sister. And if I didn't love him good enough before, I love him more now than I could have ever imagined. See, I know that nobody's trying to take them away from me. 'Cause I took them away from myself. And that's something I would never have understood a year ago. But now, I would never do anything to hurt them or keep us apart ever again. I know Mrs. and Mr. Arnold have done some very good things for Matthew, and I thank you for that. But Matthew's my flesh and blood, and I know that he wants to be with me as much as I do with him.
Miss Nickerson, your separation is going to be almost twice what we usually permit. But if everything you say is true, I believe the child would benefit from being reunited with his family. Therefore, after you have served your sentence, I will allow you a reasonable length of time to find a job and establish a home. At which point the court may give its approval for your reunion. Until then, Matthew is to remain in the care of the Arnolds here in San Bernardino County.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Everyone's a comes. So where you at now?
I'll give you 3 guesses.
Getting down with some luscious hunk of male flesh? Going to your favorite restaurant?
No.
Taking your kids out to the ball game?
Yeah. I see you've had them too.
We all have babies. One time or another, we all have.
Janice. I'm nervous.
Me too, honey. Me too.
Next to the yard, inmate Soldado, board the ADM.
Been waiting so long for this day. Now that it's here, I'm scared to death. Boy, I hear you. Well, at least you've got your kids to go out to. Someday you will, too. By the time I get out of here, it'll be too late.
Big day.
For better or for worse.
Ideas and faster feet.
Kill me?
Never happen.
Bye, Angie.
Hey, Billy, see you. Take it easy, girlfriend.
I'm gonna miss all you fruitcakes!
Then come back soon.
Not gonna miss you that much.
Good. This here.
Mmm. I feel like I'm in heaven. I haven't smelled anything this good for 18 months, 6 days.
Billy, a breast or a leg?
A leg, please.
You're up early.
They used to pop the doors at 6:30. I'm used to it.
Billy, I don't think it's such a good idea talking about that place every chance. Especially around Tiffany and Grant.
Honey, where's the...
I've got it, Bob. It's right here. I just need the classifieds.
You don't have to move out today.
Sorry.
You sleep well?
Fine.
What is it?
We just got in this big fight. It was so stupid. About whether to go to Best or Grace graduation. And then it was about, I don't know, everything. And now he wants to break up with me.
She's my daughter. Let me handle this.
Like you've handled everything else?
Well, if you've done such a great job, then where's her brother?
I tried. You think I didn't try?
Thank you. James, I'm sorry. I know you didn't have to do all this for me.
I did it for them.
And you did better than the best you could. And I'm sorry. I've just felt so guilty about everything that happened, I forgot to say thank you. So thank you.
You're welcome. I did it for you too. There's something I've been feeling guilty about too. When I told you that Van never tried to get in touch, it was true when I said it, but after that, he sent a couple of letters here.
Where are they?
I threw them out. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
You seem to know a little about cars. So, why don't you tell me some more about yourself? Where have you been working the past couple of years?
Well, I know you probably won't think of this as a job reference exactly, but I've been...
Home raising the kids, huh? Hey, it's no crime. I bet you developed a lot of patience while you were at it. And boy, that's one thing you're going to need around here. Like when you got 20 customers lined up, all crying for their cars at the same time. Yeah, that's just perfect. So, you start tomorrow morning?
You bet.
Great.
Guess what? Greg and Beth's mom decided to have one class party for everyone.
Oh, I bet I know who you're going with. That's great. So you see, everything turned out all right after all. Guess what else, Tiffy? Aunt Janice and Uncle Bob are going to loan us the money for a first and last. And tomorrow I'm borrowing Aunt Janice's car so that we can go apartment hunting. Unless you have something else that you have to do.
It's not that.
Well, honey, we can't live here forever.
Well, can't we just wait? I mean, at least until after graduation.
What do you think?
It's worse than the last place.
Well, a coat of paint would help plenty, and I could make curtains.
Mom, you're not serious.
Oh, honey. This is the best one we've seen so far. And if we clean it up...
I'm not moving in here.
We have no choice. We can afford it. There's room for Matthew.
I have a choice. Aunt Janice will let me stay if I ask her.
You're my kid, damn it! If I say that we're gonna live here, we're gonna live here!
Mom, everything was okay until you came back! I don't know how to get through to you, and I can't do it myself.
I'm sorry. It's just that we've looked at so many places, and they're all so...
I know. But I promise you, if we clean it up and we make it our own, it won't be so bad. I promise you.
Okay.
Control AR, open stereo, remove the fogger. Watch this. See the seat go back like that? It's four positions on the way back. Watch this.
George,
move that steering wheel out to the box.
Mr. Kennedy,
please come to the front office. We have a customer. Yes, excuse me.
Billy?
Yeah.
No. I know you don't want to talk to me, but I really need to talk to you.
What are you going to say?
Not here. Can't you get away for 5 minutes?
Yeah, let me look it up.
I'll wait for you. A half hour. In the coffee shop down the street. Would you like a cup of coffee?
That'll be fine.
I'm glad you came.
Before you say anything, I want to let you know that I didn't get to read any of your letters because my sister threw them all out.
Damn it. Well, I had to take that chance. I couldn't send him to the prison.
Why not?
Because I was in trouble. That shipment wasn't watches. It was drugs. The cops were looking for me.
Don't you know that seeing me could violate my parole?
Sure. But I'm cool. I got a whole new idea. I got a whole new ID and a fantastic real estate job in San Jose. The place is booming up there. With all this computer stuff, I'm telling you, I'm gonna make a killing. I'm already doing about...
Is this what you came to tell me?
Billy, I came back to make good on my promises. Now, I wrote you in those letters. There wasn't a minute went by when I didn't worry about you in there. I already put a down payment on one of those Spanish-looking houses with a pool. It's in escrow. It's not Laguna, but it's got 9 rooms and this view. And it's just waiting for you and your kids. And then there's this. Now, I know this can't make up for what happened, but 2 tickets to Acapulco, and they're paid for in cash. Billy, I need you. Give me one more chance. Hey, baby. Nobody ever loved me like you did.
And nobody ever should have. You know, man, I'm really happy that you came back. Because now I know that I don't need you. When I think of how I let a lowlife like you come between my children and me, I don't believe it. But I suppose I should thank you for that lesson. And as for Acapulco, you're gonna have to find yourself another sucker. Because I'm not your baby anymore.